What's up, everyone? I'm Tatum. I'm back with another episode of Flowers. For those that's new to my channel, this is my segment where I like to give some of my favorite albums or albums that I just think deserve a little bit more love. They're Flowers, hence the title. Before I get into the album that I picked today, I want to let everybody know, before we move on, just hit that subscribe button if you can. Hit that like button. Get ready to leave your comments. Today, I'm going to be talking about one of my favorite albums. It's one of the albums when I was younger was prevalent in my life and pretty much my whole surrounding family members, my household, my cousin's household, my auntie household, my whoever was around, this album was playing. So today I'm going to be discussing Jill Scott. Who is Jill Scott? Words and Sounds, Volume 1. This album is so freaking, it's just so amazing. Like, Who is Jill Scott is like, I can't even put it into words how great this album is. I could still listen to this album. I'm not even gonna say it like that. I'm still listening to this album today, front to back. You might catch me in my car just jamming to this as loud as possible. It's one of those albums that, like I said, it was prevalent in my upbringing. My childhood, came out in 2000, so I was, 10? Just a great, 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 great body of work. It's hard to find a body of work that can match up to this. One of the ushers of the whole neo-soul sound, live instrumentation, and what Jill Scott can do vocally and performance-wise is just second to none. And I just wanted to touch on a few of the records on here, some of the records that mean something to me, some of the records that probably mean something to you if you're watching this. If you haven't heard Who is Jill Scott by now, shame on you, and you should go listen to this album immediately. Like, cut this. This is the first time I'm going to say this. Cut this off, go listen to that album, and then come back and check this out, because that shit is just monumental. Jill Scott's from Philly. This album dropped in July. Late July of 2000, 2x platinum. It's probably her most successful album. Two things I'm pissed at is that, like, I was supposed to go see her last year. COVID fucked up two things. I was supposed to go see her last year. I think it was the 20th anniversary of the album. I ordered two vinyls of this album, and COVID fucked up the whole shipment and everything. I never received them, and I've been heartbroken ever since. But nonetheless, this album is still fucking amazing. So let's just get into it. The album starts with the Jill intro. One thing about Jill Scott that's really dope is that, in this album, is that she incorporated poetry and spoken word and even like some opera into it. Like, she's been go-go's in it, soul's in it, blues is in it. Anything you could think of, she pretty much conquered on this album vocally or just performance-wise to me. That's just my opinion. And the subject matter, oh my gosh, Jesus Christ. Just love, man. It's just so black and beautiful. It's just ridiculous. Do you remember? Like, do you remember? Yeah, remember me. That should just feel like a good Saturday. Like, she remember when he bought his first pair of sneaks, you know? Like, that line always stood out to me when she's talking to him, and she's like, I was there when you got your first sneaks, you thought you was the shit type shit. Just her storytelling with that. It's a bunch of songs on here that just put you right in the story, including Do You Remember Me? That goes into Exclusively, where hello, 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 hello. And she tells a story about how, you know, she just made love to a man. She went out to the grocery store to fix him some breakfast, to hoping to come back and get some more of that. And the checkout lady is like grilling her and eyeing her. And she like, what the fuck you looking at type shit. She's sniffing. She sniffed. And, you know, she points out the guy that she's dating. And she's like, what? Hold up. What? And then it goes into You're Getting in the Way, which I think is probably one of the first songs I heard from this album. And when I heard that, I was just like, oh my gosh, at 10 years old, I was like, who the fuck is this? Like, this shit is amazing. Like, just heard having the whole story of like, you getting in the way of what I'm feeling between me and my man, and here you come with your big mouth talking about that you seen me on 24th Street with some other cat, $9.99 or something like that. Like, it's just so many like dope stories that you could visually see. Like, and I'm pretty sure a lot of females can unfortunately relate to that, like the woman who's trying to intervene with your love that you have for someone else just out of jealousy and things of that nature. Everybody can relate to that to in some kind of state. But she painted that story so perfectly. Like, queen shouldn't swing, but you know what I mean. I'm about to take my earrings off, give me some Vaseline. You better chill. That's all I gotta say. Long Walk, probably one of her most pivotal records. I remember I was in, sixth grade or fifth grade, something like that. And I was singing this. And I came home and told my mom, I was like, yeah, we was listening. Matter of fact, we were in the car. I remember vividly now. We were in the car and the song came on. And I was like, singing it. She was like, you know this song? I said, yeah, me and this girl was singing it in class today. She said, what? What are you doing talking about singing this? What you know about taking long walks? Like, I don't. We just bond over the song. If you know my mom, that's just like extra funny. Conversation, verbalization, stimulation, share our situation, temptation, education, relaxation, elevation. Or maybe we could talk about, like, or maybe we could see a movie, or maybe we could see a play on Saturday. Or maybe we can roll a tree and feel a breeze and listen to a symphony. Or maybe we could chill and just be. Or maybe we could take a cruise and memories and passion fruit. That's my favorite part. Sorry, I'm fanning out right now, but that just shows you how much I love this album. I think it's better, which is kind of like an interlude to me. Like, I think it's better that I tell you now. He's so good. Like, her vocal performance is so amazing. And she's not, and this is just me being like a man right now. It's just like, she's not putting down anyone. Like, she's not putting down the man or anything. If anything, she uplifting her black brothers throughout this whole album, for real. Even later in the album, Brother or Watching Me is kind of like, I could relate to that as a black man, you know what I mean? Or just being black in general. That goes in He Loves Me, which was dedicated to her husband at the time. And that song is just beautiful. Like, it's just, he loved me more. And then she's like, invite me to Cora. La da da na 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 na. Like, it's so jazzy and blues, and it's a bit of opera in there. And it's like her vocal performance. And I never seen her live, and I wish I can. Like, that's like one of my life goals, is to see Jill Scott live. So all I have now is just YouTube videos to watch her live performance. And her performance while she's doing that song is just breathtaking, man. And she has a live album that was filmed in DC, my hometown, so that's pretty dope as well. It's Love, where she, me being from DC, I love this record because it has Rare Essence on it, and she's doing the go-go sound. And I remember this song played so much on the radio growing up. Just la 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 la, say what, la 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 la, give it to me, do you want it on your biscuits, baby, do you want it on your black eyed peas? Like, man, this album is so fucking great. And then like the first 9 records are just bangers. Like, she could have ended the album at The Way, which is probably one of my favorite songs on here. Great story. Like, she paints the whole visual of, like, woke up this morning with a smile on my face, cleaned up my place, jumped out of bed, took a shower. Like, it's so many, made me toast 2 scrambled eggs, grits, everyone's favorite line. Grab my keys, grab my purse, grab my jacket off the work, beaming all the way down 3rd, is it the way? And even the second verse, it's probably my favorite verse on the album. I'll get to later, but it's just great storytelling, man. Great. And even in the video when she's like at the art gallery and shit, and she's seeing herself on the wall performing and shit. Just great memories, man. Honey More Lasses, great record, man. Love Rain Down on me, down on me, great record, man. Like, it's so many gems on this record. Like I said, if you haven't listened to this album, you shouldn't even be at this point in the video. Slowly Surely is one of my songs that I came to fall in love with later in life. I fell in love with that song. It became one of my favorites. Like, it's just so dope. That sample flip. Dun, 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 dun. Slowly, surely, I'll walk away from that old good old fashioned love. I just don't know where I should go. Like, it's just so fucking great record, man. One is The Magic Number, excuse me. Watching Me, where she discusses, like, you know, people, I just came in here to get this, and you asking for my identity, you asking for my social security number. And she was like, I decline or something like that, where she like flips ID. The line is slipping me right now, but it's like the way that she flips like a double entendre of ID. And I just thought that was fucking amazing. But just great song, brother. Showed Me. Try, which is later in the album. I think that kind of ends the album, kind of like a bonus track in a way. And, you know, Love Rain remix with Mos Def. But all in all, this album is just like, it's just precious, bro. It's just so fucking dope, man. From, I'll just get into it in my recap, but let me get into my favorite songs. I'm gonna go with Slowly Surely, The Way, and I'm gonna go with He Loves Me. That was so hard to pick. I'm gonna go with He Loves Me, with A Long Walk right there, right next to it. Worst song, I hate to do it, but I'm gonna just go with Try. Best line, 4:30, can't wait to get home. And then her friends in the background on the phone, I know, nah, girl, I got something else to do. Damn, Jill, you can't be frontin' on you. Don't be frontin' on your girls. And like, nah, really, go ahead, get your groove on. Cause the nights my man's coming through. Like, oh, word, yeah. And then he's like, the conversation's just so dope. We gonna have to connect some other time. As much as I like to shake my thing on the dance floor, I got another nasty freaky just right way in mind. Tonight, I'm gonna beat the high score. Like, that's just my favorite. Like, that shit is just like, like, I just got to rewind that every time I hear it to this day, and that shit's like 21 years old. But let's wrap this shit up, though. In closing, again, Jill Scott, just thank you for this fucking masterpiece of yours. Like, you don't even understand how much this, well, you probably do, but you don't understand how much this album impacted me as a black male, just growing up in the early 2000s and getting that woman's perspective and hearing, like, you just pour your fucking heart out, man, and just be vulnerable and create all these magical stories and your vocal performance. And you gained a fan in me forever from 10 years old to 20 years later. So, like, I even listen to the Jill Scott podcast every week. So, like, I just love her perspective on things. I love her music to the death. Living My Life Like It's Golden cheers me up. Every time if I'm feeling down, I'm putting that song on, even though it's not in this album. But this album is just a masterpiece, and for it to be your first album, it's just, I don't know what you was on. To be truthfully honest with you, but you definitely influenced me. You influenced all the women around me, my older cousins and moms and aunts, and you just gave them a soundtrack to, for lack of better words, relate to. So I appreciate you for that. You introduce it to them, they introduce it to me, and I'll pass it down, so on and so on. So that's pretty much it, man. Flowers for Jill Scott. Who is Jill Scott? Words and Sounds, Volume 1. If you haven't, again, listened to this album, go listen to that shit right now, or you shouldn't even be at the part of this video. But I'll put this album up against a lot of things, man. A lot of things. It's just beautiful. And that's it. As always, though, I'm Tatum. Peace.